help us. There's an attachment that goes on the loader. As Chris mentioned, we really can't do the roads with it, but we can do the parking lots with it. We could probably do the cul-de-sacs.
It would help.
Yeah.
It's a plan right here.
Yeah.
Which will free up the truck.
Right.
So I'd like to make a motion for that.
Is it going to stop, is it?
It's the last one.
I have one to stop. It's the last one. Just as we decide, it's 42 footer. And Ambrose is the cul-de-sac?
That's a big one.
A big one, absolutely.
And school is notified on the vacation of those roads, so it should be one of the lessons down those streets.
I haven't checked, but I know about a week ago the other time.
No, we waited for paperwork to come back from over at one of the schools.
What about the post office?
The mailbox was up?
I think the mailboxes are gang mailboxes. Yeah, that cold spot, too.
Kind of narrows down the target, huh?
Kind of where we're cleaning up the mailbox area?
Hmm?
For the mail to be delivered?
I don't know, this reader's up there.
What do you mean, on the sidewalk?
It's right off the curb.
Yeah.
Did you say that we were responsible for that, crossing that?
That's a good question.
That's a great question.
You know, your mailbox or our mailbox?
I mean, not down, but they don't.
That's what I'm saying.
That's a good point.
True question.
Right, that's a question as well.
What about over here? It's like the mailbox.
It's the same type of, yeah.
So do you guys clear those down?
And we have thing there.
Yeah, because we don't do. We don't do Rocky Knolls or anything, right? Their mailboxes.
Yeah. Pretty soon they want us to live in the mailbox. It's a question for what? I don't think that's part of our. Yeah, your mailbox, you wanted that.
So we could totally. We could totally. To clean the mailbox.
Well, we are only responsible for the itself, the mailbox.
Interesting.
It is very.
On my hand, I didn't like say it.
You say, really?
He's got a lot of stuff.
Oh, we have run it out. Yeah.
I wonder why.
Let me check.
You just had a division of boxes on the street.
Yeah, I'm surprised at that.
I would say only no more, they don't do that anymore. Individual mailboxes.
Really?
But there are things.
That's where the post office decided to cut back.
Right, so this is back to this. Did you vote on this? I don't remember.
No, we made a motion.
Without, there's no question on the, will be snow days, will be more snow days.
Yeah.
Thanks, Charlie.
Just take a little longer.
Take a little longer?
Trustee Kumbawak, yes. Trustee Sampson?
Yes.
Trustee Lodato?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor?
Yes.
I think that was it.
Just real quick, while Chris is here, I don't know, Liz has a lot of things that she's got to get up to speed on, but the building, the building. Fixing it, not fixing it.
We should be.
Your building, with the accident.
I keep calling, I get voicemail, that's all, yeah.
But by law, can we just fix it and build the insurance company?
We could.
I mean, why, it's been 2 years now.
Why don't we call, you call our insurance company, get their insurance company, call us. And let them fight.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yes. Call our insurance company, let them fight.
I was told to call them, and tell them to call, and
in 2 years.
Yeah.
Take care of that. Okay. Also in your packet here is a, the letter of resignation from Diane. Mike Aiello, he's our go-to person for Delaware Engineering. He provided a quote with the new meters, new water meters. We were using Sensus water meters. This here is leading the way to what I think we eventually want.
It was on violin.
They are the sole distributor, and I have a letter that we would have provided.
I think they were gonna have three different kinds of meters. They can't read the meters, they think they're one. They can have three different kinds of meters. Well, they got two readers for the Sensus, some touch reads, there's two different touch reads that they. Are you gonna have a third one?
We have a whole list of meters that need to be exchanged, so rather than, and this will lead us to the.
Who created all this? What was that?
The list that came out from.
We know that they have to be exchanged?
We don't know.
We don't?
No. But rather, what I'm saying, rather than keep buying meters that we really can't do anything with, we should look into buying meters that would be running at the time, that we would be selling read.
I mean, I like the thought, the long term of that, but what's the issue with the touch readers?
Nothing, but if they break, are we going to replace the touch meter? Are we going to replace the meter that's going to, get to the end? No decision now.
Nope. There wouldn't be a decision now. There's a lot of talk to do.
Yeah.
A lot of learning.
I haven't
talked to this guy yet. No, I just, I don't.
When this eliminate, the guys walking around getting drunk?
No, eventually.
Oh, okay.
Eventually. We're looking at getting down the road.
But this would be a step towards it?
Yes.
How would they do it?
It's starting to.
Oh, I know.
Got a lot.
She changed them a couple of years ago.
You know, what we could start doing is putting a meter like this into hydro. Or a meter like this into roofing.
They're already in.
Well, exchange them. Exchange them out. It's a commitment on the village.
And the village covers the cost.
Yes.
We buy meters, yeah.
Now, if you remember the, this conversation, I think we started at 500,000. This was 4 years ago. And before we left the meeting, it was up to 1.5 million, if I'm not mistaken. Right? We never left the room.
Yeah. So this is 488.
That's the whole thing right now. That's the whole.
For how many?
So this is for
481.
Yeah.
The entire village?
Yeah, for the, which one?
That's good to know.
488. So it's all, I think we got electric work for the.
They said he's our go-to person. Story went, he was working.
Give me a price to somebody else.
They're the only ones that.
Only one. Just that. Oh, okay. See, that bothers me. Only one.
I have the letter that he sold. And our system here on hardware, software level, will work with this. So we're not looking at anything on this back end. But it's a commitment that I spoke to Mike Aiello.
So we know, we told you, I told you, Jeremy.
Yeah. And
mean, if it's going to involve everything on the back.
My guy wants them, so he's going to say yes.
But I don't really think he's going to go yet.
Okay, that's what I'm saying.
So, question, once everything is automated, if we do this, when you kind of come up with its own program, when will you need another program for the printout process? So this wouldn't have to really be.
No, it's just that whole thing. It's really in the infant stages of this whole thing. I know it's a very large commitment. If we were to take this whole thing, and I said we will take the whole thing if you get us a grant. If you give us a grant, we'll, I'll install it. Then you can go fix the leak. That should be fine.
I agree, grants would be awesome.
You know, sitting at the meeting the other night with Colin and hearing surrounding areas, people that gave their testimony, were pretty good.
That was our word?
It was quite interesting to hear what people had to say. That Mayor Woodbury, I believe it's Woodbury. Now there's a formula, you know, so you should only be using this much water, but when there's 15 people in the home, you have to get that into it. But as far as our water was concerned, quality of water, very good shape. Chris Finnegan says that we meet the standards of Department of Health. And I don't know what those standards are. I just don't want to meet the standards. I want to exceed the standards. So something we need to get on to see. But maybe we do meet them, exceed them. Okay. Couple of announcements. Saturday we had.
Go back to the. So one is 1257 55?
Yeah, it's the one.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that. What do you think?
146.
Oh, yeah.
That's a touch one.
Yeah. There it is. That's what I mean, it's a big one.
267 55.
That's what it is. That's what the cellular transmitter, that's what the. I added these three.
But we don't need cellular transmitter right now. That's what
the I don't know that you can really add it on later.
Yeah, we have some.
Yeah.
And what do we think? What 40?
Six.
A few announcements. I'll get back to number three. Saturday we had two great things happen in the village. We had the dedication of Veterans Park, of course, from Betty's, with the five branches of service, and it was a good crowd that day. Girl Scouts sang God Bless America. Their rendition of God Bless America. And that was followed on Sunday by Woofingtonville, which grew from last year. So I think it was a great day. You know, last year was postponed a day, so who knows what would have happened last year. But so two great things happened over the weekend here in the village. Our next major event is Whoville, I believe. Correct? Well, no, Heroes Walk, which is, we kept changing it. November 23rd, I believe? So do we have a brochure for that, so I can promote it?
Okay.
Not yet. Colleen was working, Colleen Doyle is heading that up. Dave Pritchard is going to be doing that, just recognizing. He's also going to be recognizing the Colin Schmidt. I don't know what anybody is.
Colin Schmidt, what's that?
He's doing, like, he did the...
First responders.
The first responders, and now it's military. Tomorrow's election day. Good luck, everyone.
Thank you.
And as soon as I know where to vote, I'm going to make my... Do we know where we go vote?
Go to Salisbury, no.
You go to Salisbury, right?
Yeah.
You went to Nancy Thomas last year, they sent you down.
About 2 years ago.
I'm hoping I go to Nancy Thomas. I like to keep my business...